Alright, I really understand that I haven't been posting many videos and I've been getting slower in, but I've been, I guess, trying to sustain myself with editing and more editing instead of normal gameplay, and that's because I really love editing. But now I don't have any ideas right now, and it's been like a week since I've done anything, and I'll admit it's totally my fault for all of this. I don't know. The gameplay got boring, so I tried editing, and then editing, I don't know. Editing isn't too boring, but there's not many times where I can just wake up in the middle of my night and my folks not notice that I'm playing computer, just so I can, whatever I dreamed up comes into my editing, which was for the past 3 or 4 videos, is exactly what happened to me. But, you know, that doesn't happen too often, so I'm not able to do it all the time. So, but, well, I forget my dreams. Everybody forgets their dreams. And when you forget your dream, you can't make the video, which is totally me right now. I can't remember my dream, so once I dream it up, I wake up in the middle of the night and I have to do it. That's how I work. But maybe I should stick back to gameplay videos. Luckily, I just reinstalled Total Annihilation after all this trouble that I've had with all this cheating AI and, you know, the cap of 250 units, which is usual for the normal Total Annihilation, but I don't know. There was something wrong about it. Oh, what's going on with my mouse? Mouse, you're not on a grid. Should I do SWAT 4? I mean, like, I've got the game from, what was it, the Drakelings clan or whatever it's called, these guys right here, who gives a shit? I do, actually, no. Hey guys, you guys are, faggots, I love you. And I leave, because that's how this community works. I wish I could do more with this community, but nobody actually, you know, talks to each other much at all. It's really one of those places where people group up, like, oh my god. Now that I think about it, it's almost like high school, where you go to lunch and there's a bunch of groups of people, and if you don't know them on the first day, they shun you. Which is how my life works right now. I'm with a group of people that I never knew on the first day, and they shun me for it. So I stick next to this one girl that thinks I'm always lonely, which I kind of am, but I don't give a shit because I'm a sociopath. You know, I study psychology, and I've been recently looking into what classifies a sociopath, and I'm pretty much, 42% a sociopath, and that's all it takes for me to believe I'm a sociopath, and there's nothing wrong with that, because apparently, thanks to studying psychology, I now know there's a big difference between a sociopath and a psychopath. Sociopath, he chooses not to care, and a psychopath, he cares because he can't care, which is really nice. Do you know that Total Annihilation video I did a while ago? The last one I did, the small one where it has like dun 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 dun. Well, that's Break the Glass, but I never actually showed the song on the description because I didn't think it was worth. Break the Glass. Django Django. I'm just gonna look them up onto my YouTube right here. I think Break Glass is almost probably one of my favorite songs of their album Born Under Saturn. Let's see. Break the Glass. Oh, here we go. Break the Glass. It's an okay song, I guess. Nothing too great. Oh, by the way, if you're wondering why I haven't done one of these chats before, it's because I've been lazy, and every chance I get, I don't do it, and when I don't have a chance, I regret the times that I do have a chance. So finally, I woke up in the morning, which is a perfect time to refresh yourself and do something. And, you know, it's Friday, so I don't go to school till 8:40 instead of 7:20 or something. or whatever. So, oh shit, that means, no, that means 8:15, oh shit, no, it's 8:15, I gotta do this quick, damn, well, let's see, no, don't got nothing I can think of. You know what, I've been thinking about it, you, the way YouTube works and the way that you get paid, well, first, do you know how, you know how YouTubers try to hide how they get paid? Apparently Social Blade will show it up on, anything. Let's see, Alpha Moon Man. Ah, what a slow computer, come on. Okay, so it's a grade C channel. I'm okay with that. Damn. Oh well. Let's see. Oh, what do you know? Many, many views. I don't know what this network is. I am connected with full screen. Let's see. I've made what? I have not made any money ever at all. I don't even have a bank account connected. What the hell is this? Well, if I can make a dollar in a month, that just goes to show just how much money YouTube will pay you for views. Also this guy, BlueJake42, let's see. He's got maybe 110,000, no, it went up, like, immediately. 164,000 subscribers, basically 165. BlueJake42. Let's see. So he's a grade B. Well, I'm not too far from him, plus, yeah, he's one of the people recommended in my channel. According to YouTube. So let's see, he makes, wow, up to $7,900 in a month. Of course, that's just the tippy top. The lowest he could get is $492 a month, which is still quite a lot. I don't think I'd be able to make that if I went to Applebee's or something. Estimated yearly earnings could be up to $5,900. Well, that's not too much, but I'm sure he's in the middle somewhere, and that's still pretty great. So he's only been doing this for maybe 5-6 years, and since I'm such a young person, I'll just be doing this in my spare time, and soon enough I'll have maybe a bunch of subscribers and what? Channel tech people. Huh. Weird. People? He does video games. Whatever. Let's see, Roblox. I have nothing for Roblox. All these games are just, like, bullshit to me. Like, it's the same old. People are just taking the big, amazing, cool ideas that are so cliche as hell, and they're just turning it into their own game. Like, paintball. Oh, that's so original, so original. You know, there's so many of paintball games out there. Murder Mystery 2, there's many murder mystery games out there. The Egg Hunt, which is just Easter related. Apocalypse Dying, whatever happened to Apocalypse Rising, or Apocalypse before that, god. Laser Warfare, I played it, it's not even a good game, it's just, these people, they don't know what they're doing. Like, not many people band together to make a game together. There's not many people that are a full team of people making a game. Thusly, it should be an indie game, but it's not. It's totally a game where they just copy off some other person's idea from some mainstream game. There's a bunch of there used to be a bunch of Five Nights at Freddy's games. Oh my god, that's such an original idea. God damn it. Fuck, Catalog Heaven, I guess that's a pretty good original, but it didn't take any new features, it just took all of the catalog things and put them together. Now everybody likes to kill each other with just the weapons. No, like, nobody likes to wear cool hats or anything, or play music together, because that's what you can do. You can play music. There's also tools for pranking. You can prank people. You can throw pies. You can put a piano on top of somebody and play the piano while the piano is crushing them and they struggle for it. That's funny. That's a prank, I guess. Tix Memorial. I don't know if you've heard about this, but the most famous currency of Robux, Tix, is being removed within a month or two, and nobody's happy about it. So everybody's all like, bring back the Tix, you know, stuff like that, please save the whales and shit. Adopt and raise a cute kid. See, now this is the stuff I used to do. I guess it's sort of original, or stuff that doesn't get old. You know, back in 2009 when I first joined Roblox, there were a lot of raise a cute kid games, and that's where it became unoriginal. But soon enough, it's becoming original again, I guess, because nobody's using it, or at least it's less of a cliche in this generation of Roblox. But whatever, ultimate driving, people seem to love driving so much that they'll make a game about it. I don't know I don't think it's much of a selling point in my mind. Dinosaur Simulator, I guess somebody likes dinosaurs or something. Let's see, more Lizard Warfare, soccer, more horror games. Tycoons, so much tycoon. I mean, almost the top playing game right now is like tycoons. I understand like people use tycoon, but I think they're using it incorrectly. Tycoon is just one of those names people use. See, this here, Lumber Tycoon, is an actual tycoon as I've played it before, and you've seen my extremely edited video of it. I was pretty proud of that video, but you know, I'm not anymore because I suck at editing and I have too much pride when I post a video. Lumber Tycoon 2, it actually is a tycoon because you're making a company out of yourself. I don't know if I'm the first person to do this, but aside from doing the work myself, I had sooner enough made enough money to make facilities for people to do it for me. And I would just go and get special wood and I would give it to them and I would get better payments. But since I made so much money out of other people's labor, it technically was a tycoon. Because a tycoon is a company where people work for you. And in these tycoons, Bank Factory Tycoon, Update Gold Rush Tycoon, and other sorts of tycoons, it's not really a tycoon. It's just basically one of those shitty trading games where they say you trade shit, but no, you're just gaining money from nothing other than things that you click if you have enough of the numbers, where it says the number is that money. And that money just goes up from nothing. See, Retail Tycoon is half of what a tycoon really is. You know, you are getting money from nothing, out of nowhere, but people do come and buy your stuff, and you have to take inventory, do stock, and I guess, you know what, that's actually a very good thing for new people going up into business like I am. In school, I work hard as hell. I haul ass up in school. Day and night, well, not day and night, but I wish I could, because I'm a workaholic. I don't go to sleep till like 12 o'clock at night, or maybe 1 in the morning. And I take sleep medicine, but that don't work. I just happen to love working so much that I can't sleep. And when I can't sleep, I love working. But the miracle that happened yesterday, just yesterday, over at in the 7th, I worked my ass off so hard from working for the custodian, working for a student store, as you know about, if you have one over at your school, student store. Let's see, I work for this thing called the Academy. Instead of a library, we have an Academy, which is for students that don't have the appropriate credits to graduate. So they go over there and they study their ass off. Well, there's a food room where students get food after school, so they can study after school and not get hungry. Well, people take advantage of that. But I stock for them, and that's nice. Like, I don't know, it's work. I'm a workaholic. Who cares? I care. Fuck. I also, the student store, I stock for them. They say it's, like, the most boring job, and if they say that stocking is the most boring job, I'm gonna have fun, so much fun with the other jobs, because I like stocking a lot. And the janitor, I think I worked for him for 2 hours, so for the first time in a while, that was a lot of standing up and working and dexterity. I had, in fifth period, I had fallen asleep. I had basically passed out from all the work that I had done, because I'm not used to that kind of labor, but I wish I was. But I don't think I need to be, because I don't know how to explain this. I think I have the ability to stay awake for a few days and not care if I'm hurting or not, as long as I get to do work. I'm a person that likes to get a little down and dirty. Other than that, I guess retail tycoon really takes into account what people can really do in real life, such as take inventory. I guess it's an okay thing. I remember when it was in the beta, when you had to buy access. So many zombie games. I guess it's died down now, but it was pretty bad back then. But I'm still going to consider this a cliche. I think I've played Tiny Tanks. I tried to record it. It was too slow for my recorder, and so I never actually posted it. I think. I can't remember if I posted it or not. Whatever. Base Wars. What an old game. I feel like this took inspiration from Desert Warfare, if you know that game. Wasn't too extreme of a scripted game, but this is extremely scripted right here. New space games are coming out, Starship Roleplay, and this EVE Online spoof, if you've seen it. I don't know, I just did a bunch of mining. When I had enough money, I bought a cruiser and started hunting alien ships. I gotta stop talking for a second. There's a lot of survival games out there. I think they take inspiration from Call of Duty and Killing Floor. Broken Bones has been around for a long time. So has Galleons. Galleons has been around for a long time. He's the one that made Armored Patrol and Urban Patrol. I've only posted a video of Armored Patrol. But let's see. See, this game, I think it's a finished game. He's basically stopped working on it. Galleons, it's basically now a finished game. But he does patches on things that, you know, break, because Lua keeps changing for some reason. Crossfire is a weird game, but I like the concept. World of the World seems to never get old for people, because they still keep playing it. You know, ships come around, they vaporize people immediately, you throw rocks at the ships until they die, which is stupid, kinda. That's really about it. As far as those other games go, Total Annihilation, I figured out a consistent way to get recording on it without it crashing as much. Open Spades, I'm sure you've looked it up or not, but, it's basically, the Ace of Spades beta was build and shoot, and so Open Spades never got its name changed, because it didn't really infringe on any of the copyrights of the new Ace of Spades, so there's no reason in changing the name. So now it's just build and shoot and Open Spades. Open Spades uses build and shoot's servers, the same servers, but it's a graphics overhaul. So the people in who use the build and shoot client will see build and shoot people. The people with Open Space will see something along the lines of something really beautiful and epic and awesome, but it takes a good graphics card, and I don't have that. I have a Radeon 3000 apparently, and it sucks ass, I guess. So I can do Open Space on the lowest graphics settings and probably get a good 30 frames, but if I was to record, it would go down to 5. So, no, I can't do that. But I finally got Elite Dangerous installed and it didn't work. But my folks say that within a month or two, I may be getting a new graphics card that is able to run Elite Dangerous quite well. And when that happens, possibilities will go up. Now, Battlezone, I'm sure you, maybe some of you have wondered. For the older subscribers, you may have been wondering why I never got back to this game after the first two parts, or first two or three parts of it. Well, there was a mission that just kept crashing my game after some point, so I don't know, couldn't do that. I tried multiplayer, but for some reason the connection is so very bad that that also crashed my game, so I gave up on Battlezone. I don't know how it's gonna work. Guns of Icarus, it's so graphically extreme. I put it down to the lowest graphics and I still get 5 frames. I've played it that way before, but can't record it, you know. Studio, I thought about using the studio, but it is limited in its own way. It's really those game, really one of those things where it's blocky for a good reason, but it has some pretty good physics. Total Annihilation. Oh, I don't know. I'm gonna be doing more of that, but now with no cheating AI, I can finally have more fair fights, and I can lose less as much as I usually did, because that was a big problem. Because you know that cheating AI, they just built one of their quantum disruptors or whatever they're called, and they just basically have infinite resources forever. You know what? It just never ends. And then they start building like extremely powerful armies, and they build the most annoying thing, which is bombers. They just keep bombing my shit, and I can't do anything about it. I mean, I have anti-air, but I don't know. Like the rockets don't do crap. You know, I gotta have like multiple just to take one out, and then they have like 5 bombers, and I have to like build all these anti-air, and I can't do nothing about it within good time because I don't have the resources, and they just have it all, don't they? By the way, this shit makes a smiley. Oh, by the way, computer info. Actually, no, I probably shouldn't show that. I'm gonna edit that out later on. It's getting close to that time where I have to leave. So, Robocraft. I think that was just a one-shot deal because, just like r r the Roblox games, I really don't do it more than once. I think it was just because I really loved my how gun bad of my robot it was that I just wanted to show it more. Well, at least show it to YouTube. That didn't get so many views as much as it does for Total Annihilation, apparently, and my trailer, which is, it's unlisted, but it's on my front page if you want to see it. Unlike other YouTubers, I don't ask for more subscribers, and that's because I don't want any kiddies coming around and just subscribing because I asked them to. I gain my subscribers from people who want to actually see me. I'm not going to ask for subscribers because the people who really want to see me subscribed for me. But subscribers, I don't know what it's gonna do. Oh, by the way, for people who dislike my videos, I just thought of it co something cool. Apparently, dislikes boost the popularity level of the video as much as a like does, or even a subscribe. So you can dislike the video all you want, but I actually use my liked videos as another playlist for things that I just like, such as the Moonlight Sonata. I don't just like anything anywhere, and if I have a video that I don't like anymore, I unlike it. And it's just one of those playlists where I like things. Oh, what the hell? I just gained a couple more subscribers, I think. Well, shit, it was just down 46 a second ago. Damn, things happen fast. And my favorites, same as my likes. If you haven't seen Factorio, you might like it. It's quite a nice game. By the way, I wanted to, I want to ask about, you probably also use your liked videos, but you want to boost me if you do. I don't know if you do or not. I'm not watching you like a stalker or anything. If you want to boost my videos in popularity, which, I don't know, might help by a little bit, but not too much, because with 48 subscribers, it might just be just incremental. But if you want to boost my video, but you use your liked videos as a playlist for something you actually like, and you don't do it just because you're trying to boost a video, then dislike it. Because dislikes do the same thing as likes do in boosting the popularity, I guess. Oh well, I think my grandma is gathering everybody up to take to school. I think I'm going to end it here. There's other things I want to talk about. If you want to wonder anything about my YouTube channel, feel free to ask in the comments. Like, I am truly up there and on there. Now that I have a phone, I am looking through my Google Plus more. I wish there was more I could talk about. There's so much more I want to talk about, but I can't. This is my opportunity for a long... This is the only opportunity I'm going to get for a long time. Because sometimes I'm lazy, and that's just how it happens. So, see you guys.